Hello, in this video, we're going to look at UV package manager for Python. It installs and manages Python versions, runs and installs Python applications and so on. You can see it all here. So I'm not going to kind of bore you with all the details and just talk about the documentation. What I will say just before we go too far is I'm just going to say I've previously tried Poetry. I've previously tried Rye, and there were just little niggles with them, which probably stopped me persevering with them. But having said that, with UV package manager for Python, I probably will persist with it. And I know you have to get out of old habits. So when you run your code, you don't type Python main.py anymore. You would type UV run main.py. You could also set up aliases in your zshrc or your bashrc file. So I don't see that really being an issue. When I installed Rye, I had lots of problems when I tried to revert back to using normal Python. And I just got in a bit of a mess with it, really. So not of my own making, I don't think entirely. So this is the installation. On a Mac or on Linux, you can just do this command. That's your Windows command. So install it, install UV. Once you've got UV installed, then you can start a project. So what it does is it basically uses pyproject.toml to manage your dependencies. And you can call your program using UV. So instead of doing pip install, you do UV add. So everything begins with UV. If you want to run something, it's UV run. There's lots of other options, which I'm not going to bore you with. You can see those in the documentation. And without me taking up your valuable time. So just let's just quickly run something and just go to my Python directory. Let's do UV init YT for YouTube video. And it's initialized the project. And we see what we got there. So if we change that directory, I do tree minus, what should we do? Tree minus L3. You can see what it's built. So let me just make that a bit bigger. There you see you've got your pyproject.toml. And it's just built you a kind of a skeleton. So you've got, it's made you a source directory and a YT video directory. So basically you'll have to navigate down two levels before you can start writing your code, which personally I don't like. With Rust and Cargo, which is very similar to this and what I believe inspired this, you only need to drop down into SRC, but with this, you'll need to drop into SRC, then into YT video. So you go down two levels instead of one, which you would do with Cargo and Rust. But so if we want to add a, let's just add requests. So just UV add requests. And you've got, it's quite nice really, because it just gives you a bit more feedback than you would see with pip install. Very, very quick. So the speed is notoriously fast. I know speed's not the be-all and end-all, but it is 10 to 100 times faster than pip. There's your graph there, look. So pip sync, PDM, poetry, UV. It's written in Rust, and that's whether you like Rust or not, that's beside the point. It just means it's fast. So if we come back here and clear that, and then we've got it's built a README, which will be empty or fairly empty, I believe. Yeah. You've got a lock, so that's nothing new there really. So if we go to pyproject.toml, it's just started your boilerplate version description, README, blah blah blah. There's so much you can put in here, and obviously you can then tailor it to whether it's a development, you want to run it in as a development mode or in production. I'm not sure what hatchling is, but I'm sure we'll all find out in due course. So if we go into SRC, so then you've got YT video. That's because you could have more than one project within sort of like sub projects, whatever. CDYT video, and then we've got init.py, which is good. And then we just do NV is just my shortcut for NeoVim, by the way. just because I'm too lazy to type nvim. I suppose I could have just changed it to vi, really. And there we go. So, yeah. Import requests. res equals requests dot get, and then what should we do? We do Google dot let's get google.com. And then we'll just print a response. Res dot, let's just do status. Exit that, and then we just do UV run main. And oh, it's got status code, sorry. I'm a bit rusty. Let's just do let's just do res.content then. Let's go crazy. There we go. So it's gone off and got the Google homepage. So yeah, that was just uv.run. Oh, sorry, UV run, and then the name of I'm thinking over time I might just I might just set up some aliases for like UVR, which is just to run the instead of UV space run. But now we're really just getting kind of silly with trying to automate things to death. So UV run, UV add, those are the two main ones that I would start to use just while I'm gonna, you know, try and learn more about it. But you could use I think it's rough as well, isn't it? Rough is a lot faster than I've already installed rough, so rough UV run rough check. Again, I'd probably just set up an alias for these, because especially if you're not a great typist, which I'm not. Rough check path. Now, what have we got? UV run. Sorry, it should be UV rough check main.py. There we go, all checks passed. Sorry about that. So yeah, that's quite a lot to type, really. I would just set up a shortcut for that. So I'd just do UVRF or something, just an alias UVRF, and then it would save you typing all that. But again, that's kind of getting a bit ahead of ourselves, really. So the question is if you install UV, will it kind of compromise you when you're trying to just run Python normally? And we're already here, so if I just do Python main.py, it still runs fine. When I was messing around with Rye, I had issues. Rye worked and it would run my code, but when I tried to go back to Python, it didn't. So obviously you got your different versions, so that still works. With UV, I wonder if UV run, I don't know if you can specify the different, well, I'm sure you can specify the different Python versions. So if you wanted to run it with 3.10 or 3.12, so anyway, it's here. So I would recommend just do the curl script if you're on Linux or whatever operating system. Linux, Mac, and if you're doing the Windows one, then what was it, PowerShell, whatever. You can do pip install as well, even easier. I don't know if that'll live, if that, presumably they'd want to discourage the use of pip in the long run because they want you to use UV. But a great project as far as I can see, and I think it had some updates this week, so that's kind of why it caught my attention. Add license text. I think it was kind of not so much launched, but I think it was given a bit of an upgrade or a boost this week in some shape or form. There we go. Look, it was just something happened 19 minutes ago. So it's really, it's moving fast. And I think this is probably going to be just easier to transition to. As I say, poetry and Rye, slight learning curve. But this is just UV run, UV add. Look, pretty much if you just want to just use those two commands to get started, I think that's really, that's sufficient. So I think that's one of the problems when you migrate to something new, you don't want to be having to take twice as long to do something. You want to be as quick as you were at your old method before you, and then you can obviously build upon that. So yeah, you don't want it to slow you down. And I think switching to UV will not slow you down. And it builds you your well, what it does is it makes every Python project effectively, it makes it have the same structure, which I think is long overdue. And we get back up. And there's so much more to it. We've not even touched the surface on it, but installs, manages, runs and stores and single file scripts, inline dependency, metadata, comprehensive project management, pip compatible, supports workspaces. Yeah, and if you've not tried Ruff, give Ruff a try because it's very fast. And there we go. So that was a quick look and just my kind of thoughts on using UV. And I don't see any reason not to try it because it's quick. It's not going to compromise your anything you already know. And I can see this probably becoming... I don't know if it'll ever get included in Python itself, but it's just fast, straightforward, and it kind of... I think the power of it actually will be in the pyproject.toml, because that is where you can really do sort of powerful things, granular things, etc., etc. So, thanks for watching, and I'll be back soon.